Ready?
Yeah.
All right. Hello, guys and gals. This is your hippie with Harmony, Mojo Daddy Mystic. I'm back with my main man, Uncle Ted, and we are going to get into some Gil Scott Heron with his song, Home is Where the Hatred Is. Now, Uncle Ted, drop some knowledge on Mr. Gil Scott Heron. Where did he come from?
If I'm not mistaken, Gil Scott's from D.C.
From Washington, D.C.?
If I'm not mistaken.
Okay, so he's a local boy.
Yeah. He's from D.C., if I'm not mistaken.
Wow.
Yeah. And I forget what university he went through, and he wrote a paper, and he got his master's degree after writing one paper.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah. He was brilliant, man.
Brilliant mind.
He was brilliant.
Wow.
Oh, yes.
So what I know of Gil Scott Heron is Revolution Will Not Be Televised. And That's like one of the first, you could say the beginnings of like rap.
Right.
Very, very poetic. And but we're going to take a look at this song, Home is Where the Hatred.
Yeah, he and Nikki Giovanni.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Because mm-hmm. I have Nikki Giovanni's very first album.
Like, is it like Spoken Word?
Spoken Word. Yeah. Truth Is On The Way is the name of the album. I got it from 1971.
Yeah, man, we might have to.
Okay, no, I'm sorry. We're going to stay on this right here.
Let's stay on Gil Scott. But did he write this or was it somebody else?
Initially, I heard someone singing. Her name was Esther Phillips. I haven't done the background to say who wrote it. But I heard her singing it first, not saying that she wrote it, but I heard her singing it.
Okay. Yeah. All right, well, let's take a look at this. You've heard this before.
Yes.
So this is going to be a review.
That's okay, but it's always fresh. You know, if you put it on, it's always fresh. It's always fresh.
We got to hear something.
Yeah, it's got to be fresh. Come on, let's roll.
Let's do it. This is an ad. Wait for that ad. But yeah, man, I had to drop some knowledge on yoga yesterday.
Yeah.
The revolution begins.
Just walk through the twilight.
Takes you back.
Yeah. A junkie walking through the twilight. I'm on my way home.
Yeah, you see.
Yeah. I left 3 days ago, but no one seems to know I'm gone. If I never went home again. Stand as far away from me as you can and ask me why. Hang on to your rosy beat. Close your eyes to watch me die. You keep saying, kick it, quit.
He's talking in the
perspective of turn your sick soul inside out.
Like it's so hard.
Such a bad idea.
Deep, man.
Oh, yes, sir.
That's
yes,
deep.
Sir.
So, yeah. Breaking this down, as I said, he's talking in the perspective of an addict.
Yes, yes.
He's saying it's so easy for you to say to stop or kick the addiction, whatever that may be.
Right.
But it's not that easy.
Right. And, you know, like it's just like with Oxycontin. You know, a lot of people say, well, you can do it, but if you ever had excruciating pain that numbed you,
like painkillers,
yes. But if you've never experienced it, then you don't know.
You don't know what it's like in his shoes.
So judge ye not.
Exactly.
Yeah. Yes.
But again, man, brilliant guy.
Yes, he was
so talented. He's got to have some type of recognition because
he
is one of the first, like, truly revolutionary rappers.
Yes.
Honestly.
I mean, he was a honest revolutionary, and he couldn't be bought. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He wasn't at the White House trying to get a dollar.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
He wasn't gonna sell out.
And then some people even went to him, like he even gave people money and money without any expectation of getting it back. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He truly lived by his credo of, you know what, he was an artist that believed in what he was singing.
That's an artist, man.
Yeah, exactly. He believed in what he was singing.
And home is where the hatred is.
Right.
Can you, just real quick, can you break down what you think that means or what this song is trying to tell you?
Well, you know, you...
It's crazy.
Well, you're in a family situation and you have an addiction, a substance abuse problem, and some of the people that should be nurturing you, but some you've offended so many times, they don't want anything to do with you.
They've given you so many chances.
So whatever they define chances are, right? So I don't want anything to do with you. And then you have the other ones that, you know, give them another chance. You know what I'm saying? So it's a house divided against itself.
And
unfortunately, well, we can say, well, all type of people look and say it's in African American, but it's in all communities.
Oh yeah. This has nothing to do with the color of your skin.
Right.
Addiction is something that
it's just
affects.
Like it's just like COVID-19.
Exactly.
Yeah, it ain't respect.
That's perfect. Yeah. That's a perfect
analogy. Yeah. It don't respect where you live at.
Exactly. It don't respect your bank account.
Right.
It don't respect.
It don't respect your address.
Right.
Because it's killing folks in the ghetto.
Right. And it's killing folks. Well, it's almost killing somebody in the White House.
Reservoir Road where the rich white folks at. Great Falls. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm just saying it doesn't respect. Addiction doesn't respect your address.
Yeah. Exactly. And you have to be smart.
Right.
That's what I'm saying. You can fix. What is it? You can fix. What is it? What's the quote? You can fix. What's the quote? You can fix.
Well, I'm gonna let you ride with it, son.
Oh man.
That's okay.
I wanted to drop some knowledge.
That's okay. But you know what? People can feel where you're coming from. But my whole thing is, unless you've been in dire straits, right? You don't know. You don't know how it feels. You know, if you never had a psychological or a physical pain, because a psychological pain, it really cuts deeper than a physical pain because you're still living with the trauma. It's like an assault, right? Do you want a physical assault or a mental assault? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Sometimes the mental is even
worse. Because it keeps popping up. You know, it hits you, or something, a trigger. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, you know, this is why people have to have therapy or support groups.
Yeah.
And this is why music is therapeutic.
But that one quote, it's you can fix naivety or what's the word for being unaware of something? It's on the tip of my tongue. It starts with an I.
Yeah.
It's not incompetence. It's... Like you don't have any knowledge of something. Let's say you want to be a doctor, but you don't know anything about that. So you're, what is it?
Well, I'm gonna have to.
I'm gonna have to sip my cup and come back to you on that one.
That's okay, man. That's okay.
Oh, man, it was so profound. I'm sorry,
okay, but you know, that's okay.
I'm drawing a blank.
There's nothing to be sorry about. You know, you put the thought out there, and somebody's going to plug in what you're saying. But the important thing is we are all human, and we're all at different points, all different times in our lives, you know, go through a grief process, some living with grief. And we all, if we live long enough, we're all going to live with some type of grief.
So, the quote is, or it's not really a quote, it's just a saying, you can blame somebody for being ignorant of something.
Right.
Or, I mean, you can give somebody for being a pass for being ignorant.
Right.
But you can't, you know, give somebody a pass for being just plain stupid.
Right.
You know?
Right.
So.
Okay, I can ride with
you
that.
You kind of get what I'm saying?
Yeah, I can.
So, what'd you guys think of Gil Scott Heron, Home is Where the Hatred Is? Very powerful, very moving.
Right.
I had to,
and it's timeless.
Exactly. This is one of the songs that are timeless.
Right.
It has no time period.
Right.
It can relate to addiction, all generations.
Addiction was here before I got here. Addiction is here now, and it'll be here when I leave here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So don't get caught up. And if you have any troubles, talk to someone.
Right.
Because addicts, sometimes they think that they don't have a problem.
Right.
Or they say that.
Right.
But, and they're, sometimes they're just afraid to tell somebody that they're
right.
A problem.
Right. And then some people say, some people are judgmental. Let's just be clear.
Let's be real about
there
it.
Are those people that have no problems living in a perfect world. You know, now I don't know what world that is, bizarro or whatever.
Right.
But there are those perfect people that have
no
problems.
Fantasy world.
Perfect height, perfect weight, perfect amount of money. You know, so there are those few people. So you don't want to talk to those perfect people.
Like
you know?
Bougie?
Yeah. Well, they're beyond that. They're in they're in an altered dimension.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
They live on.
They're in dark matter somewhere. Yeah.
They live on heights.
Or Death Star out there with Star Wars time. You know.
They're too rich for my
world. Yeah. In another world, man. Let's die.
Alright, well.
Okay, we're gonna come on back.
Alright, let's come on back.
Come on back.
What'd you guys think of Home is Where the Hatred Is? We enjoyed it. That was just a nice, chill song. And we're out of here.
Peace.
Love. Alright.